When deciding to further your education, what comes to mind? What obstacles do you see yourself having, and what's stopping you? A lot of people even start education or start furthering their education, but they never make it past that point. They never actually graduate. So what's stopping students? Our plan is to create an application that can help everyone continue their education and finish it. Some of the resources that this app will have is deciding where you want to go to college before you even go there, learning about resources on campus, and creating a teacher-student relationship through profiles that can help teachers understand how students learn, what their study habits are, and even include suggestions for the classroom. This will benefit all students, prospective and current.
Research shows that mental health related difficulties play a big role in students furthering their college education. In a research study done by Higher Ed Connects, 1 in 5 students are struggling with mental illness, and many of them are very good at hiding it. To put that into perspective, there are over 5,000 students at USF St. Pete campus. That means that over 1,000 of these students struggle in some way with mental health. Now let's talk about dropouts. In a study in 2016 of 3,146 students between the ages of 16 and 29, 8% of these students dropped out, all of which reported mental health related difficulties. Poor mental health was significantly associated to dropout among students in vocational and higher education, was also a quote from that study. Typically, mental health problems are invisible, and we don't see them until someone reaches out or does something drastic and it's too late. A quote from a report by a former student says, "From the perspective of my friends, professors, classmates, and advisors, though I was happy and adjusting fine, on the inside, though, I was falling apart. I called my mom crying almost every day. It was a struggle to get out of bed every morning, and I honestly couldn't imagine that I would ever be happy again.
This is Katie. She works full-time as a waitress and full-time as a student. She's currently 27 years old and she pays for her schooling and all of her bills. She's incredibly hardworking as she pays for her housing, her food, and her schooling. One of Katie's main concerns and the reason that she used our app initially was because Katie has an overwhelming amount of anxiety and she feels very depressed. The reason that she used our app was to make sure that USFSP was going to be the school for her. When she used our app, she was able to talk to advisors and see that she could attend school full time instead of the part time that she initially wanted. She was able to talk to an advocate from the Student Disability Center without needing to meet with them in person. So she was able to talk to that advocate through the app, and that person was able to schedule her extended testing time for her in her classrooms with the teachers. So it was completely confidential. The teacher didn't need to know that Katie was involved, and that teacher was able to grant extra testing time for Katie at a testing center. So she was able to get several things alleviated before committing to school, and it was able to help her still be able to afford schooling as well as working full-time at a job, since those were her main concerns that she addressed on our app. So this would be Katie's journey if she didn't use our app. So Katie would be going into school after having a gap year because it was way too stressful for her and it was too much to handle and she didn't have the money. So if she didn't use our app, she wouldn't have gotten in touch with those advisors that she needed. She wouldn't have gotten in touch with the Student Disability Center and she wouldn't have been able to find out that she could do full-time schooling and full-time work because the advising and the disability center would schedule extended testing time and additional resources for her on the campus. Her senior year, she would have way too much going on between her workload, her school load, and her clubs. On her very limited free time, she would be looking for a full-time position, but she wouldn't be able to go to the interviews or do anything that she needs to secure those positions because she's going to be so busy with work and doing everything that she needs in order to graduate. But if she had used our app, she would be able to talk to different jobs in the area, maybe even have more free time because she would be talking to advisors and teachers in confidentiality and they would be able to work something out for her. Katie has finally graduated. She finally finished school and she's so overwhelmed. She did it completely alone. She didn't have the help of our app. She works as a bartender now, didn't quite develop those proper coping mechanisms. Had she used our app, she would have been able to talk to her 24-hour assistance line and get the mental help that she needs. She's very short on her bills every day, and she just doesn't quite feel like schooling was the best for her. But if she didn't go at it alone and she used our app, our services, talked to everyone that we could, and set up a personalized schedule for her, it would have been a much more efficient graduation. The solution that we came up with is a mental and physical wellness app. So our app is going to start off with kind of a pre-screening. From there, you can put in certain things that you struggle with, whether it be anxiety, depression, those sorts of things that you're initially concerned about before attending school. Then from there, what the app will do is personalize resources for you. So let's say that you were in the St. Petersburg area and you wanted to know what kind of college you would like to attend. You could put in your stressors or your main concerns. If for you social anxiety is something that you deal with, you would put in social anxiety and it would pick certain classes and schools for you with the least amount of people. That way you could see what fits around your personal needs. You can also choose health and wellness options. So one of the selections on our app has hobbies and interest. From there, if you were a person that was interested in art or fishing, it would give you certain places to go for pottery classes or fishing classes and different opportunities for DIYs and certain things like that. There's also a chat board section, so you can talk with your advisor personally instead of face-to-face. That way it stays confidential and you don't have to deal with that burden of meeting with someone. From there, you can also chat with other students in the classes, kind of get a feel for things in a more personal light. There's also additional resources on that app that you can select and choose, whether you want to find healthy eating recipes, maybe even like some yoga or Zen therapy. And then when you go to the app, your main page will kind of ask what you want to focus on for the day. There will also be a calendar that you can select and choose. The calendar can include resources on campus or personalized activities that you would like to do throughout the day. Our example of the calendar is resources for a student at USF St. Petersburg. They have a health educator live meeting in the morning, and that would be with one of our confidential advisors or mental health advocates. Then in the afternoon, they have a relaxation group. They go to yoga after their class, or I'm sorry, they go to Zumba after their classes. That was one of their interests that they selected for health and wellness, but they could change those interests every day, whether it be gym classes or DIY craft classes, anything on campus that they offer. And then they have a risk management in the afternoon, and that is their calendar that they customized through our app, and it worked off their location and their interests completely personalized to them. This app really helps incoming college students focus on finding what works best for them. One of the reasons that people don't attend college is because they're concerned. They don't think that they have the time, the money, or the resources to go. This app will help alleviate some of those stressors and pick and choose a school that's going to be the most understanding for their mental and physical needs. One of the ways that our app does that is by doing a college pre-screening. So before you get the app, like I mentioned earlier, you can see schools in that area.
see schools and what they offer for you in terms of their mental health programs, their fitness schedules, things that are of interest to you. In the habits and health section on our app, that's where you can customize your calendar, pick and choose your day, and see what's in your area and on your campus as resources to you. There's also the chat board, so you can chat with students that are already at the school and advisors that are there as well. They'll be able to help pick and choose your schedule, give you guidance, and help alleviate some of that anxiety before you get to the campus. The additional readings are also things that are based off of their personal preferences, like the recipes or gym schedules for the day. There's also the 24-hour assistance bot, which you can see underneath the icon. It comes up and says, "How can I help you today?" That will be where you put in what you're basically looking for the day, or just certain things that you need extra assistance with, and that will always be available to you. There's also the campus resources section, which is if something isn't on your calendar but you want to see what your campus has, you can visit their websites that we have linked, and the app is 100% personalized to each individual.
One of the features of our app is a student profile. This gives a communication between the teacher and the student without them having directly to come to them. This will teach the teachers how students learn and how their mental health might be affected in the classroom. Mental health affects every student differently in the classroom. Some things include adjusting to medications, environment stimulus, handling time pressures and multitasking, and responding to negative feedback. Not all students will have the same difficulties, and not all students are diagnosed with a mental health disorder. When diagnosed with a mental health disorder, the only way students can receive help in the classroom is by reporting these mental health issues to the guidance counselor and putting them on record. The point is to create a platform for all students, not just those with diagnosis. Anyone that needs accommodations in the classroom should have that opportunity. The student profile will also create a learning platform for teachers so that they can learn about their students and adjust to their learning needs. Teachers can adjust their teaching types semester by semester so that the students can get the most out of their courses and learn what's most applicable. This is also the time for students to give suggestions and to adjust their own courses because they're the ones learning from them. The current solution for students suffering from mental health disabilities is online school. Students who attend online school are not able to access all school benefits, including counseling. Even when they have access to these counselors, most of them don't know how to help. 80 to 90% of students that commit suicide never receive help from their school's counseling system. Many teachers are not educated on mental health, and they don't know how to properly handle people with these medical conditions. Teachers can be strong influences in students' lives and can be the reason someone finishes their education instead of dropping out. That's why this student profile is so important, to create that connection and to create that influence that a teacher can have. Whenever a teacher knows what the student is struggling with, they can help improve it or change their lectures to accommodate them. As students, disability services can help if they register. This can extend some deadlines and decrease testing anxiety. For some students, just registering is an anxious assignment and can deter them from even doing it. This is why we should create an environment to reduce mental health restraints for all students. Creating a student profile in the application creates a place where a teacher can know all of their students and their study habits and how she can help the student individually according to their college stressors. This creates a confidential environment for all students to be honest about what they need in the classroom. This also gives teachers a chance to adjust to their students and change how they are over the years. Everyone learns differently, and maybe new students can bring new suggestions to the classroom that will help other students in the